Welcome to the BuildBlock ICF Installer Training Series.
Penetrations, beam pockets, and blockouts. In this video, we will identify common wall penetrations in ICF walls and take a look at different methods for creating, bracing, and sealing penetrations. There are several types of surfaces where it may be necessary to create penetrations in ICF walls. These include electrical or generator surfaces, telecommunication, water lines, sewer and septic, natural gas or propane, geothermal, and air conditioning lines. It may also be necessary to cut penetrations for several types of ventilation, such as kitchen exhaust and range venting, bathroom vents, dryer vents, heat recovery ventilators, and furnace venting. Lastly, mark and cut openings for access to satellite, cable TV, internet, and telephone access, as well as any pet access doors. The sleeve for a penetration should be constructed to the size required and no larger. Typically, PVC pipe is used and placed through an ICF wall. The pipe should extend past the ICF several inches until the final wall is poured. Use spray foam adhesive around the sleeve on both sides to seal the sleeve in place and prevent any concrete leakage. If multiple penetrations are close to each other, be sure to brace and strap as necessary and use proper vibration techniques to ensure there is proper concrete consolidation around all penetrations. When cutting penetrations, ensure that no debris fall into the wall cavity. If it does, remove it prior to pouring the walls. Beam pockets are also common in some designs. Consult your engineer to determine the proper placement height of bearing plates and size of beams if required. Cut out foam and web ties to accommodate the bearing plate. You will need to brace the back side of the beam pocket as well with 3/4 inch plywood or 2x4 scabbing. This will help support the back foam panel if the web ties are cut through. Reuse the cutout portion of EPS foam to bulkhead the sides of the pocket. You can also create small bucking from wood to hold back concrete on both sides of the beam pocket. Secure the bulkheads or bucking with adhesive foam and/or screws to prohibit movement during the pour. If a bearing or weld plate is needed at the base, insert it after you have poured the concrete. You will want the pocket to have slaked but still be workable. It is critical that the height of the beam pocket is correct. Shoot all beam pockets with a laser level to ensure placement is correct. On solid foam, cut slightly larger than the beam pocket size and then secure and pour in place. Finally, keep in mind that beam pockets and placement will impact other trades such as framers and truss engineering. During the plan review process, ensure that the location is noted and planned for. If you suspect by examining the plan that you may need to install a beam pocket, communicate with trades and engineering to obtain specifications and placement. Add these locations to the pre-pour checklist. More information can be found on BuildBlock.com or in the BuildBlock Technical and Installation Manual.
Thank you for watching this video in the BuildBlock ICF Installer Training Series. For more information and other videos in this series, please visit our website at buildblock.com/training or our YouTube channel at youtube.com/buildblock.